911. What is your emergency?
Hello?
Ma'am? Hello?
Please. Something's happened.
I need you to calm down.
My sons are missing.
What are your sons' names and ages?
Max and Daniel Kovacs. They're 24, 29. Oh, God, I feel sick.
I have help on the way.
Oh, God, please, God, not my son.
Ma'am?
Please, not my son.
Hello? Mom. Mom, calm down. It's fine. What's wrong?
I still can't get a hold of him. Something's wrong, Max. He's not in jail or the hospitals. I'm ready to call the police.
He's done this before, Mom.
Please, just go check on him. Please, if I were down there, I'd go. It's been a week now.
Call Dan.
Hey, reach Dan Kovac. I can't get to my phone right now, but if you leave me a message, I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks.
Hey, it's me. I'm on my way to your house, so if you get this, call me so I can turn around. I don't know what's going on, but you've got Mom freaking out. Again. Call me. Hey, I'm here.
Is he there?
Doesn't answer his door.
Well, you need to go in. Just go in. He has a spare key hidden somewhere in the backyard. Under a mat or something.
All right, let me call you back. Who's this?
I'm only going to tell you this once, and I mean it. Do not involve the police.
Operator?
Hello, can you tell me the last number that called this line?
I'd be happy to assist you. Can you please verify your address? Hello?
Sorry, 1032 Pine Street, Los Angeles, California.
Thank you. Give me one moment, please. Okay, the last incoming phone call I'm showing for you was 5 minutes ago, and it was received from a restricted number. Unfortunately, I can't give you any more information than that. Sorry.
Can you tell me what area the call came from?
If you'd like, I can set up your line to reject restricted calls.
No. Thank you. Who is this? Hello? Who is this? Hey, what's Dan's birthday?
What for? Did you get in?
Yes, I'm trying to get into his computer.
June 16th, 1985.
All right, let me call you back.
Is his stuff there?
Yeah, everything looks fine. Let me call you back, okay?
Well, call me back in a few minutes. Love you.
Bye. Dan? Hello?
What's going on, Max? Is he there yet?
No.
I'm calling the police.
Mom, no. Don't freak out. I think he went on a trip.
What? Why? Why do you think he went on a trip?
Because it looks like he packed clothes. His neighbor said he thought he was going to his friend's or something like that.
What neighbor? What friend?
I don't know.
Well, go ask him if he knows his friend. Maybe he... I hate this.
Mom, calm down. Please, calm down. Everything's gonna be okay. Maybe his phone got shut off.
He hates me?
Mom, it's okay.
I'm a terrible mother. Everything's my fault.
What? What are you talking about?
I'm a terrible mother. He blames me for everything and I'm sick of it.
You're not a terrible mother.
And he better not be driving. His license is suspended.
I know.
That's Aunt Paula. I'll call her back.
Talk to her. Calm down. Everything's gonna be okay. I'm staying here tonight in case he comes home.
Okay. Well, call me if you hear anything. I love you.
Bye. Love you.
Back. I can't get to my phone right now, but if you leave me a message, I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks.
comes with me.
Okay.
Apologize for silencing you, quieting you. I'll explain later. But
okay.
Well, this way.
So it's Friday evening,
I had my friend over and we were hanging out, and I just realized, I checked and I got my call sign from the FCC, so we brought my little radio out and it's on that table right there. And I'm about to make my first transmission as an amateur radio operator. Hey, Johnny, I think your dog just went in the house. Oops, sorry. Okay, guys, hello, this is Dan Kovac. And again, I just received my call sign from the FCC, so we brought the radio outside. And I'm about to make my first transmission as an amateur radio operator. All right. Cool. Hi, this is K33RSG. Listening. Making my first transmission as an amateur radio operator.
This is Dario Vivo Tango. I think I just heard someone say this was their first time on amateur radio, and I just wanted to give you a big warm welcome to the hobby. I'm David.
Yeah, thank you. It's K33RSG here. Thank you for the welcome. I am transmitting here from Los Angeles, California. I'm curious, how does my radio sound?
Sounds fantastic. Sounds like a bass rig running a kilowatt. Crystal clear audio, beautiful modulation. Really couldn't sound any better.
Hey guys, Dan Kovac again. Today's a cool day. I just bought my first very own shortwave radio. If you're a new subscriber, let me explain to you really quick what that's for. I have been listening to number stations online. A number station is a radio broadcast that transmits onto shortwave radio bands, and they send out basically coded messages by reading off sets and sets of numbers, or even letters. Some of them are even sounds. What is fascinating about them is that most people would argue that they cannot be traced. It's a radio transmission, so unlike an email, it does not have an IP address, or a phone call, you know, can be traced. You technically, if you put a lot of time, effort, and money into it, could trace where a number station is transmitting from by taking multiple radios and kind of narrowing down where the strength of the signal is coming from. If you have a cipher or what's called a one-time pad that's meant for that specific station, you can decode what these numbers mean, because these sets of numbers correspond to letters or whatever it is, you know, that this one-time pad translates them into, excuse me. Another thing I found fascinating was a older form of delivering a covert message was to shave someone's head, tattoo this message onto their scalp, let their hair grow back, and then send them to whoever it was that this message needed to be delivered to, who would then shave their head and uncover this message. That's a whole other thing we'll get into later. I'll do that in a separate video. But for now, I'm going to drive home and we are going to get this bad boy fired up, and we are going to look up some number stations. If you like my videos, please subscribe and hit that like button somewhere down here. I really appreciate you guys following me, and I'll keep you up to date with my licensing information and everything to be an amateur radio operator. Peace. Yeah, this is K33RSG. I'm here in Los Angeles, California. Whereabouts are you?
Oh, I'm around. You know, I'm around.
Okay, well, can you tell me how far from Los Angeles you are? I'm trying to make long-distance contacts. Thank you.
Daniel, how long have you been transmitting?
About a year. I received my call sign this year.
Congratulations. You know, I'd like to continue talking to you, but today, I am painting a wolf, and I would really like to finish. I'd like to speak to you further. Would you like to give me your contact information? I have some very valuable information for you about the hobby. Things you might like.
That would be great. Hey guys, so today I just wanted to do a quick video to kind of explain the necessities of what you need if you want to get into amateur radio. I'll kind of tell you what I did to study for the licensing test, and different beginner equipment. It is kind of an expensive hobby, but there are some beginner radios out there that are fairly inexpensive if you want to go the handheld route, or there's several different options. A lot of people actually build their own radios too. That's a whole other thing.
I'm a room, please?
You'll need to fill that out.
I'm looking for my brother. His name's Dan Kovac. Have you seen him?
No.
Can I help you?
I'm looking for my brother. Have you seen him?
No. Why are you looking for him?
He left our motel this morning to take pictures. Didn't take his phone. Thought he might have come by here. It's a beautiful theater. Do you mind if I take a look inside?
Go ahead.
Thank you.
Delta 3455. This is Alpha Tango Whiskey 255. Go ahead.
Great. You have a crystal clear transmission here on Para. Where is your station?
I'm up in northern Nevada, Prescott. Trying to make rapid contacts here today. Thanks for yours.
Please help me. Do you have any tickets left? Is there anything you can do? Please, I'll do anything.
I'm sorry, I can't help.
This is NA6BRS. Is this frequency being used?
NA6BRS, this is Alpha Tango Whiskey 255. Go ahead.
Sid, happy to hear you are still with us. How is your pack?
It's coming together.
And how is Judy?
She's leaving.
I'm very sorry to hear that, my friend. You see, Sid, today I am painting a wolf, and I am almost finished. Our pack is full, Sid. The Dark Hand is near. Thank you.
forecast, cloudy and windy today with gusts up to 40 miles per hour. Temperature dropping to 59 degrees this afternoon. Cloudy and continually windy at night with a low of 47.
Hello?
Can I help you?
The phone in my room doesn't work. Can I use this one?
Lines are down. There's a big storm 200 miles west.
See you already.
want to show you something.
Thank you. Good morning. Before we go, I wanted to share something with all of you. Words from my favorite author, Donald Miller. I want to keep walking away from the person I was a moment ago because a mind was made to figure things out, not to read the same page recurrently. Only the good stories have the characters different at the end than they were at the beginning. And the closest thing I can liken life to is a book, the way it stretches out on paper, page after page, as if to trick the mind into thinking it isn't all happening at once. No, life cannot be understood flat on a page. It has to be lived. A person has to get out of his head, has to fall in love, has to memorize poems, has to jump up bridges into rivers, has to stand in an empty desert and whisper sonnets under his breath. I'll tell you how the sun rose, a ribbon at a time. It's a living book, this life. Folds out in a million settings, cast with a billion beautiful characters, and it is almost over for you. Doesn't matter how old you are. It is coming to a close quickly, and soon the credits will roll, and all your friends will fold out of your funeral and drive back to their homes in cold and still and silence. They will make a fire and pour some wine and think about how you once were, and will feel a kind of sickness at the idea you never again will be. So soon you will be in that part of the book where you are holding the bulk of the pages in your left hand and only a thin wisp of the story in your right. You'll know by the page count, not by the narrative, that the author is wrapping things up. You begin to mourn its ending. You want to pace yourself slowly toward its closure, knowing the last lines will speak of something beautiful, of the end of something long and earned. And you hope the thing closes out like last breaths, like whispers about how much who the characters have come to love and how authentic the sentiments feel when they have earned 100 pages of qualification. And so, my prayer is that your story will have involved some leaving and some coming home. Some summer and some winter, some roses blooming out like the children in a play. My hope is your story will be about changing, about getting something beautiful born inside of you, about learning to love a woman or a man, about learning to love a child, about moving yourself around water, around mountains, around friends, about learning to love others more than we love ourselves, about learning oneness as a way of understanding God. We get one story, you and I, one story alone. God has established the elements like the setting and the climax and the resolution. It would be a crime not to venture out, wouldn't it? It might be time for you to go. It might be time to change, to shine out. I want to repeat one word for you. Leave. Roll the word around on your tongue for a bit. It's a beautiful word, isn't it? So strong and forceful, the way you've always wanted to be. You will not be alone. You have never been alone. Don't worry. Everything will still be here when you get back. It is you who will have changed. Let's leave.
Thank you. Thank you.